Hey guys, welcome back to Explanator. This video is all about a pure inductor connected across an AC supply. We are going to talk about the voltage equation, current equation, phasor diagram, power equation, and lastly, graphical representation of power consumed in a pure inductive circuit. The approach is same like how it was done for a resistive element. If you missed out on that video, you can check the link in the description. For now, let's begin with the session. Consider a circuit with a pure inductor and an AC supply. The alternating voltage applied is denoted by the equation V equals Vm sine of omega t. Let the current flowing in the closed circuit be of magnitude I. The electrical energy flowing in the circuit is saved in the form of magnetic field in the inductor. This produces an induced EMF in the inductor of magnitude L di by dt and opposes any sudden changes in the rate of flow of current. Our first task is to find out an equation for this current which flows in the circuit. When current starts flowing, the applied AC voltage equals to the voltage induced in the inductor. So we can start the derivation by writing L di by dt equals V. Substituting the value for V, you get L di by dt equals Vm sine of omega t. Since equation for current I has to be derived, keep the current term on one side and take all the other terms on the other side. As di is present instead of I, take integral on both sides. Since integral of sine is minus cos, the solution for current I will turn out to be Vm by omega L into minus of cos omega t. To maintain uniformity in the equations, convert the equation for I, which is present in terms of cos, into sine. So equation is written as Vm by omega L into sine of minus pi by 2 minus omega t. Using trigonometric property, it can also be written as Vm by omega L into sine of omega t minus pi by 2. When sine reaches its maximum value, current will also reach its maximum value. Therefore, Vm by omega L can be denoted as Im. Using this value of Im, equation for current can be written as I equals Im into sine of omega t minus pi by 2. Going back to the equation of Im, if the terms are rearranged to get a ratio Vm by Im, it will equal to omega L. And it remains the same even when the ratio Vrms by Irms is considered. Comparing it with the equation for Ohm's law, you see that R equals omega L, which means omega L is the opposition offered to the flow of AC current in the inductive circuit. So we call the term omega L as inductive reactance. Now that we have the equations for voltage and current, we can proceed to drawing the phasor diagram. For phasor diagram, we need to consider a reference line. Let that line be of voltage. From the equation, it is seen that current lags the voltage by 90 degrees. So we draw the current phasor at an angle of 90 degrees in the negative y direction. This is a simple phasor diagram for a pure inductor. Our next step is to find an equation for power consumed in the circuit. The power consumed in the circuit is of two types. One is instantaneous power and the other is average power. Instantaneous power is what is consumed at the moment, while average power is considered over the whole cycle. For instantaneous power, you use the equation P equals V into I. Substituting the values for voltage and current, you get P equals minus of Vm Im sine of omega t into cos of omega t. Using half angle formulae, it can also be reduced to P equals minus of Vm Im sine of 2 omega t upon 2. Next, to find the average power, integrate this equation over the whole cycle, that is from 0 to 2 pi, and divide it by the total time interval. Upon solving, you will notice that the integral returns a value 0, which physically means that an ideal inductor does not consume power. The energy taken for one half cycle is returned back to the system in the next half cycle. Now that we have the equations for voltage, current, and power, we can go ahead and start plotting them. To plot voltage and current, consider a XY plane with omega t on x-axis. Draw a table to note down the voltage and current values. Mark the values of omega t on x-axis and that of voltage and current on y-axis. Tabulate the different values of voltage and current at different intervals of omega t and draw the corresponding points, that is 0, pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. To plot the power curve, calculate different values of power for different values of omega t. You will observe that for the values which have been considered previously, the answer turns out to be 0. So we need to consider more points as it is not possible to draw the plot with the given set of points. So consider some more points like pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, 5 pi by 4 and 7 pi by 4. The plot has a highest magnitude of VmIm upon 2 and a lowest magnitude of minus VmIm upon 2. Draw the waveform with this new data and you will see that the plot has a symmetric pattern about x-axis. Now, for calculating instantaneous power, you can take the coordinates at the desired time interval. But for finding out the average power, we need to consider the area. And since the waveform is symmetric, the positive areas will cancel out the negative areas. And hence, the average power consumed in a pure inductive circuit is again zero. Another approach to drawing this plot is first draw the voltage and current plot. And since power plot is a multiplication of voltage and current plot, multiply both the waves. Depending upon the polarity and magnitude of both the waves, you can obtain the resultant waveform. So plus V and minus I will give minus P, plus V plus I will give plus P, minus V plus I will give minus P, and minus V and minus I will give plus P. And you can see that the sinusoidal pattern is symmetric about the x-axis. So that was a brief session about the different parameters in a pure inductive circuit and an AC supply. Do let me know if you have any suggestions and drop in your comments. Don't forget to subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.